Hello friends, myself Preksha Parikh from LGIT. Subject is heat transfer. Chapter is convection. And today topics are convection, boundary layers and its numerical. Now first, what is a convection? Basic introduction of convection. So now what is convection? When the heat transfer from one molecule to another molecule due to the heating process or cooling process. So when the heat is transferred in a fluid as like the gas or liquid and molecules travel due to the heating, due to the heat of transfer, due to the transfer of thermal energy, then this type of process is called convection. Now total two types of convection, one is natural convection and another is forced convection. Now in natural convection, the hot atoms move upward side and cooler atoms move downward side due to the gravity without any external force and heat energy transfer from one molecule to another molecule. Now this process is done due to the buoyancy forces, which is we already studied in fluid mechanics in previous semester. Now it is also change in density due to the variation of thermal, means variation of change of the temperature in the fluid. Okay. So this is the natural convection. Now here the example of the natural convection. First one is radiator. Now radiator, in radiator warm air going to out at the top side and cooler air is coming at the downward side without any external force. So this is the example of natural convection. Now cup of the tea. So the steam you see when drinking a tea of heat, hot tea, so which is indicate the heat is being transferred to the air without any external force. Now ice melting, it is also process of the natural convection. So ice melt because the heat moves to the ice from the air. Now this is the example. So here the due to the heat is here heat is given to this fluid and molecules of fluid is circulate in this on as per the these round arrows. So hot molecules is going to upward side and cold molecules is going to downward side due to the gravity and change of temperature. So this is the example of natural convection. Now here you can see how two molecules is circulate. So hot molecules is coming from the upward side and cold molecules is going to downward side. So these are the example of the natural convection. Now force convection. So what is the force convection? So in force convection, heat transfer in fluid with the using of the external force, right? So which type of the force? So that time use the ceiling fan or pump or any suction device or others. So that time it is called the force convection. And that time the heat is rise because of we apply the force. So due to the velocity, heat will be rise comparatively natural convection. Now what is the examples? So examples is blower, hair dryer and exhaust fan. So these three are the examples of the force convection. Now here you can see the ceiling fan. So that time the fan is rotated. So it's due to the forces, the hot air and cold air are moving from upward to downward side and downward to upward side, right? So this is the example of the force convection. Now in next important topic is boundary layer. So what is the basically boundary layer? So boundary layer means the one adjusting layer which is the connect with the one plate. For example, we take the one flat plate surface and fluid is flow on this flat plate surface. So that time the one layer is attached with this surface. So it's called the boundary layer, right? So now in boundary layer, a thin layer adjusting the boundary is called boundary layer, where the viscous shear stress are working, right? That time the shear forces are working between the fluid and this boundary. And the region outside the boundary layer, when the flow behavior is like quite ideal fluid and potential fluid. So another layer is a of the boundary layer. This fluid is work as like the ideal fluid. So now consider the boundary layer form a flat plate kept a parallel flow and that time the velocity is capital U. Okay, so now through the grow of a boundary layer depends upon the body shape, flow over a flat plate aligned in the direction of flow is considered. Since most of the flow surface can be approximately a surface of a flat plate or for simplicity. Now some the assumptions are here. So the edge facing or the direction of flow is called leading edge. The rear edge is called trailing edge. Then near the leading edge of a flat plate, the boundary layer is wholly laminar. Then the boundary layer or the velocity distribution is parabolic curve. The thickness of the boundary layer is denoted by delta, which is increased with the distance of the edge x. And more fluid is slow down the viscous boundary. So become the unstable and breaks the into the turbulent flow. So these are the all the assumptions. Okay. Now in next. Now this is the diagram of the boundary layer. So this is the velocity and here the x direction and this one the y direction. Okay. So now here fluid is flow and that time velocity is u. So now this is the laminar boundary layer from this dotted line to this dotted line, and here the which type of the flow? So viscous flow, then transient flow, and then turbulent flow. Now in this flow you can see this is the curve, right? And this is the curve from the boundary layer, and this one delta. Delta is a vertical height of the boundary level, and which is called the thickness of the boundary. Okay, and its curve shape is parabola. You can see that this is the parabolic curve. Now in transient mixed flow, and then in turbulent you can see suddenly the flow is a rise, and this one the delta is a thickness boundary for the turbulent layer. Okay, so now delta is a thickness of boundary layer increase as a distance from the leading of the edge x increase. If x will be increased, then delta will be increased. Now delta increase as a kinetic viscosity increase, but obviously if kinematic viscosity mu will be increased, so that time the delta will be increased. Now delta will be increased with the decrease of the velocity, because of the height of the boundary layer will be decreased with the increase of the velocity, or vice versa. Now tau means shear stress. Shear stress on the boundary layer, which is called the mu into du by dy. Now du means u is a velocity, dy means vertical height is a delta. So u by delta. So hence here tau 0 will be decreased with the increase of the x. However, when the boundary layer becomes turbulent and it shows the suddenly increase in the vertical height delta. Okay. Now when u increase in the downward direction, boundary layer growth reduce. So these are the diagram of the boundary layer and how to work boundary layer, which is mentioned in this diagram. Now next, the characteristics. Some characteristics are for the boundary layers. So first is what is the boundary layer thickness, and second is displacement thickness. Okay, now so what is the boundary layer thickness? Boundary layer thickness means vertical height of the boundary layer. So it is a definition. However, its n give approximately value of the boundary layer thickness. Hence, delta is a generally terms of nominal thickness of the boundary layer, and which is a vertical height of the boundary layer in from the x direction. Okay, now which is denoted by delta, and total three parameter. One is displacement thickness, second is momentum displacement thickness, and third one is energy. Because of three main parameters are work. One is displacement because of fluid is flow, so it's a flow from one place to another place, so displacement thickness. Second is momentum because of fluid is flow with the mass, so momentum is created, and so we find out the momentum thickness. Third one is energy thickness, so energy thickness is a delta. Now what is the displacement thickness? Displacement thickness means the it's a depends on the displacement. So it is a distance, right? Displacement means it is a distance measured perpendicular to the boundary by which the main strain is displaced and account of formation of the boundary layer. So this is the called displacement thickness. It is another definition. We can also write down this ki wall thickness that would have to be applied to complete for the reduction in flow rate of on account of boundary layer formation. We can write down this definition or this, both are correct. Now what it is denoted by delta star. Now next one. So displacement thickness. So this is the figure of the displacement figure. Displacement thickness. Now this one the boundary layer. This one is velocity distribution. Now here we take the one strips from this curvature, from this boundary layer. So that time here the height is dy. This one the y. Capital U and the change of velocity is small u for the small strips. So now assuming you need width, the mass flow rate second through the eliminated strips means in these strips, right? So this equation is rho u dy. Rho means density, u means velocity, and dy means this one the height. Okay, now mass flow rate per second through the eliminated strips. Okay, so now for these whole strips, so what is the rho? Now that time the velocity is u and dy. Now reduction of the mass flow rate means here without the mass, per unit mass, so rho u dy, and with the mass, so rho u capital U, right? Capital U is equal to small m into u dy. Okay, now reduction, how much is reduction? So this minus this, this minus this, so rho is common, capital U minus u into dy, and this is called the velocity defect. Now next one. Now we take the integration from boundary layer 0 to delta, right? Vertical height is delta, so 0 to delta. So we take the integration in respect of the y dy, right? So now this is the one equation. Okay, now another. Let the plate is displaced by the distance of delta star. Now plate will be displaced from delta to another place, so it's called delta star. So our equation will be rho u delta star instead of rho u delta. Okay, now we simple equate these two equation, this one and this one. So we can write down rho u delta star is equal to integration of 0 to delta rho u minus small u dy. Now we compare this equation, so rho and rho both are cancel out. Now here we take the common u, right? So 1, so 1 minus u in bracket, right? And u is also cancel out. So our answer is, and here we divided capital U because of 1 is we common the u, right? So this is the answer. So our answer is delta star is equal to integration of 0 to delta 1 minus small u upon capital U dy, which is we used in numerical, and this is the displacement thickness delta star. Now in next we find out the momentum thickness and energy thickness. So now what is the momentum thickness? Momentum thickness means with the mass flow rate. So momentum thickness is defined as the distance through which the total loss of momentum per second be equal to if we're passing a stationary plate, and it is denoted by theta. Okay, so now again, what is the mass flow rate? Rho u dy, right? Then momentum, so rho u capital U dy, because of it is a momentum, so we have to write down the velocity. Now a total difference, so we this minus this. Okay, so rho u is common, so capital U minus small u dy, and limit is 0 to delta. Now let us, theta is the distance by which plate is displaced when the fluid is flowing with the constant velocity. So that time the our equation is rho theta u square. Now we compare, simple we compare this equation and this loss equal to this total. So rho theta u square is equal to limitation is 0 to delta integration rho u capital U minus u dy. Now both sides, rho is cancelled. Now theta is equal to, so u square here divided by u square, so u upon u square. So u is cancelled, so small u upon capital U coming from common, so 1 minus u upon u dy. So it is a equation, theta means momentum thickness is equal to theta is equal to integration of 0 to delta small u upon capital U in bracket 1 minus u upon capital U dy. Now energy thickness. So what is the energy thickness? Energy thickness is denoted by delta E. Energy thickness is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in kinetic energy of the flowing fluid on account of boundary layer formation, and which is denoted by delta E. Delta is a energy thickness. Now again, what is the mass of flow per second through the eliminatory strips? So rho u delta dy. Now kinetic energy of the fluid inside the boundary layer. So 1/2 mu square, right? Now what is the m? M mass is equal to, we can write down the rho u dy because of it is a mass flow rate. So here we put the value of this, right? So our equation is, kinetic energy equation is 1/2 rho u dy small u square for boundary layer and for entering the mass capital U square, right? So this is the change. Now we find out the loss. So what is the loss? This minus this. So 1 minus 1/2 rho u dy u square minus this one. So here 1/2 rho u is common in bracket u square minus small u square into dy. So now what is our total loss? Integration of 0 to delta 1/2 rho u is common in bracket capital U square minus small u square into dy. Now delta E, what is a delta E? It is a distance by which the plate is displaced to complete for the reduction in kinetic energy. So the loss of kinetic energy through the delta means energy thickness of the fluid flowing with the velocity capital U. So what is our equation? So our equation is equal to 1/2 rho u delta E capital U square. Now we compare these two equations. So 1/2 rho u delta E u square is equal to this one. And for due to this, we simplify here. Now how do we simplify? So 1/2 rho u, right? 1/2 rho u is cancelled. And this u is going to upward side. So this u cube, right? So this is the u cube is going to downward side. Now this one integration 0 to delta u capital U square minus small u square dy. Now multiply by with the 1 upon u cube. So u square upon u cube. So small u upon capital U, which is coming from this bracket. So in bracket u upon capital U in bracket 1 minus u square upon capital U square. So what is the equation of energy thickness? Delta E is equal to integration of 0 to delta small u upon capital U in bracket 1 minus u square upon capital U square in bracket dy. Now next one is numerical. Find out the value of displacement thickness, momentum thickness and energy thickness. So first we understand the example. The velocity distribution in the boundary layer is given small u upon capital U is equal to u y by delta. They give these values where u is the velocity at a distance from the y plate, from the plate y, and small u equal to capital U and small y equal to delta, and delta is a boundary thickness. Now we have to find out the displacement thickness, energy thickness, momentum thickness and delta star upon theta. Now displacement thickness means delta star, momentum thickness means theta, then here delta E, and we have to find out the ratio of these two. Okay, so now first the displacement thickness. So now what is the equation of delta star? Integration of 0 to delta in bracket 1 minus small u upon capital U dy. But we know that small u upon capital U is equal to y upon delta. So here we put the y upon delta. Now do the integration. Okay. So 1 dy, integration of 1 dy means y, and y dy. So y square upon 2, and delta is a constant. So here keep as it is, and limit is 0 to delta. So now here y equal to delta. Okay, so here we put the y equal to delta minus delta square upon 2 delta. Delta delta is cancel out. So delta minus delta upon 2, and answer is delta by 2. So this is the answer of the delta star. Delta star is equal to delta by 2. Now momentum thickness theta. So what is the equation of theta? theta is equal to integration from 0 to delta small u upon capital U in bracket 1 minus u upon capital U dy. Right? Now here, capital U equal to delta, small u equal to y. So here we put the value y upon delta in bracket 1 minus y upon delta dy. So this equal to integration of 0 to delta in bracket y by delta minus y square upon delta square dy. Now here we put the value. First do the integration. So y upon delta. What is the y dy? Y square upon 2. Delta is a constant. So here we keep this in the after integration. Right? Y cube. Y square. Integration of y square dy. So it is a y cube upon 3 into delta square. Okay? So this is the theta is equal to delta square upon 2 delta minus delta cube upon 3 delta square. And this equal to delta by 2 minus delta by 3. So what is the our answer? 3 delta minus 2 delta upon 6. Right? So 3 minus 2, 1. So delta upon 6. So this is the answer of the theta means momentum thickness. Now next one, the energy thickness, right? So what is the energy thickness? It is denoted by delta E. And what is the equation? So delta E is equal to integration of 0 to delta small u upon capital U in bracket 1 minus u square upon capital U square dy. And this equal to 0 to delta y by delta 1 minus, now here u equal to y square, capital U is equal to delta square dy. This equal to integration of 0 to delta in bracket y by delta minus y cube upon delta cube dy. Okay. Now here integration of y by delta dy. So y by delta. So y is equal to y square upon 2 delta y square by 2 and delta is a constant. Y cube, integration of y cube. So it's a y raised to 4 divided by 4 into delta cube. Now here we put the y equal to delta because of keep the limit, right? So delta square upon 2 delta minus delta raised to 4 upon 4 delta cube. Okay, now here we can multiply this. So delta is cancelled. So 1 half here delta upon the 4, delta upon 2 and delta upon 4 equal to 4 delta minus 2 delta upon 8, right? So what is the answer? Delta by 4. This is the answer. So delta is equal to delta by 4. Now what is the value of delta star upon theta? So now delta star is equal to delta by 2 and theta equal to delta by 6. Delta is cancelled. So answer is 6 by 2 equal to 3. So this is the answer of this numerical. So answer of displacement thickness is equal to delta by 2, momentum thickness theta equal to delta by 6, energy thickness delta E is equal to delta by 4, and the ratio of delta star by theta is equal to 3. Okay, so thank you. These are the answers of the numerical.